Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, he'll tell you. And it's just the kids come here because they know they have an opportunity for games. Vacation Bible School, my grade level is 5th and 6th grade, and they have me in tears. They know more scripture than we do. They teach me most of the time. My name is Reverend William Yu, and this is 15 Minutes of Heaven. I got 1,000 cards. Anybody want to go to YouTube and see this? This will be up tonight, probably after 9 o'clock. Tonight I'm talking about prayer. And how prayer changes things. And how Jesus was in the wilderness and he went to pray. So let us pray now. Father, we thank you for the opportunity just to expound on your word and teach some of your soldiers that fought through the rain just to come in. Whatever reason, it doesn't matter. They're here in the house of God. We ask that you open up the windows of heaven and pour them out a blessing. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
I'm in the good book of Luke, starting at the 6th verse, the 12th chapter. Jesus, let me give you a little small scenario. Jesus was picking the first original 12 disciples. Can you imagine that? I don't know, the Spirit led me to that because it's all day, all week, I just been on it and looking at it. And to be chosen by God, that is one of the highest honors that a living man, a regular man, can get in his life. And I'm going to break down the scenarios of the 12 because they were ordinary people. Anybody can come into the priesthood of God because we are ordinary people. All of your sins are forgiven. Our friends won't forget, but Jesus said, 7 times 70, he'll forgive all your sins. Now, who wouldn't want to learn from that? Who wouldn't want to be forgiven of your sins? I know I'm not the only one. I got some friends. They talk about stuff that we did 30 years ago. Yes, I drank. Yes, I smoked. Yes, I acted a fool. But God cleaned me up. I am you and you are me. We the same. I just chose to go with God. Get outside of myself and accept the scripture. And America won't be great again until they start praying. And that's how we're going to take back our neighborhoods with prayer. Amen? Because it's enough gunfire, gangs, drugs, and all that. But what about the prayer? So what we're going to learn tonight in just 15 minutes, and my name is the Reverend William Yu, it's called 15 Minutes of Heaven. Here's the word of truth. This is my Bible. Everything in this is true and reliable. This is my Bible. So if you want to hear some truth, and I know some of y'all do, because outside of those doors is chaos. Here's the word of truth that you can hold on to. Luke 6, starting at the 12th verse. Now it came to pass in those days that he went to the mountain and prayed. I have yet to go to a mountain and pray, but I can imagine being on a mountain and praying. I don't know if God went there to be closer to the Father. I don't know if it was a small mountain or a large mountain, but he went to the mountain to pray and continued all day and night in prayer. That's what I'm talking about. We have to increase our prayer life. He prayed all day and all night. serious. It's not that serious. The sickness is not that serious. The jobless, the relationships, the children. If we spend time praying, we spend less time worrying about the foolishness. Amen?
Amen.
Let me continue a little bit more. And it was the day he called his disciples to himself. And from then he chose the 12. He named the 12. And I'm not going to call all the names of 12 and all that, but y'all know the 12 that he chose. This is God starting his ministry. Anywhere we start in a ministry, we have to start with a few people. And he chose these 12. My sermon outline goes like this. Jesus prayed all night. Increase your prayer time. And that's what I've been doing. Trying to pray more. Trying to get to myself. Trying to go into my secret closet. I spend a lot of time in the bathroom. So I pray in the bathroom. I call it the porcelain throne. Amen? Oh, y'all don't go in the bathroom. That's okay. But you will learn that. That's a secret place. Once you shut that door in the bathroom, you got a secret closet right there. And when I'm working in the yard, in the garage, and I go into the garage, that's your secret place right there. And I go in to pray. I don't care what's going on. I learn to pray more. And it's not that serious, family. Scripture again, when Jesus prayed all night to the Father, asking for whom he would include in his first group. My sermon outline consists of this. Number one, he chose a religious skeptic. Now, how many of y'all know that talk about the scripture? The scripture ain't this, the scripture ain't that. Jesus chose a religious skeptic. Talk about the Bible, hating the Bible, always got questions. But what I do when I run into somebody like that is an answer for everything and anything. It's nothing new under the sun. It's nothing missed in that. It's nothing new under the sun. Number two, he chose a businessman. And see, when he started choosing, what I understood is Jesus don't discriminate, people do. He chose a wealthy businessman. Number three, he chose a Hebrew fundamentalist. One of the 12 was a Hebrew fundamentalist. That means that all of us get saved. The door is open for all of us. Number four, he chose a thief. Amen?
Amen.
Oh, shoot, I ain't the only one who used to steal. Steal something. When you get hungry, you do strange things. Amen?
Amen?
I used to go in the store and put stuff under my arm and stuff like that. When you broke, disgusted, and don't have no money, and you hungry, you do strange things. So Jesus chose a thief among the first 12 to be his disciples to expand his ministry. Number five, a thug. Y'all see where I'm going with this?
Yeah.
He chose ordinary people to lead his ministry. Scripture is, no one comes to the Father unless you come to through the Son. He chose a thug. Now all of us got a little thug in us. But all of that stuff is forgiven. A shady government worker. He chose. Number seven, a radical Jew. Number eight, and this is one of my favorite So, if Jesus choosing all of these misfits are the first disciples ever, and he molding and shaping and anointing them and preparing them to carry on his ministry, you can be a part of it too. And last but not least, a spoiled rich kid. Amen?
Amen.
Now, why I didn't put no names to that, because I leave that to your imagination for you to read and figure out which ones that I was talking about. A spoiled rich kid. That one should be easy because one of them carried around the money. Right there. Let us pray. Father, we just thank you. Scripture says we can do all things through Christ that strengthens us. All things, meaning all things. It's nothing that we can't do, family. If we put our mind to it, we can change our situation. But you have to change your prayer life. The people, places, and things that you engraft. Change it up. It's nothing that you can do. I pray for the people that's preparing the food. I pray for the children, my wife, my son, the ladies in the audience, the staff that's in the church, and the pastor of this great church. Let the church say amen. Go in peace.